Hello and welcome to the course CS348 Advanced Computer Network. Today's talk is on snooping TCP. If you see this syllabus, we have already covered congestion control, slow start, fast retransmit and fast recovery. And in the last lecture, we have covered indirect TCP. So today's lecture is on snooping TCP. So let's begin. So we'll start with the drawback of ITCP, then how that drawback will be managed or solved by your snooping TCP that we are going to discuss. So one of the drawback of ITCP is the segmentation of single TCP connection into two TCP connections. If you remember, then in case of ITCP or indirect TCP, the correspondent node is connected to a wire network, and this is the access point which is connected to your network or wire network. Then your mobile node will be somewhere here who has a wireless connection with the access point, and from here the division takes place in ITCP. So this part is called wired network and this part is called the wireless network. So this division was made in ITCP and this is act as the intermediary between this part and this part. So this losses the originally end-to-end TCP semantics, but our TCP says, means the regular TCP or traditional TCP says that the connection must provide an end-to-end connection between the correspondent node and the mobile node, which is not maintained in ITCP. That's why to enhance the quality of ITCP, snooping TCP was developed, which solved the problem of end-to-end TCP semantics. So snooping TCP enhances the technique and leaves the TCP end-to-end connection intact. The enhancement includes buffering the data close to the mobile host and performs fast local retransmission in case of packet loss. So to make the TCP end-to-end connection, means the rule of TCP, the snooping TCP is taken, means developed, and snooping TCP says that the technique says that there will be a buffering element or the foreign agent who will act as a buffering element closer to the wireless device. He stores all the data transferred from your correspondent node to this access point or the foreign agent. This will send the data to the mobile device, retransmitting the device whenever the packet gets lost between the mobile device and the access devices or the correspondent node. So let us understand the architecture properly, and we will discuss in detail of this. So pay attention to the discussion. So check this figure. In this figure, I am trying to show you that this is the correspondent node which is connected to the wired internet, and this is the access point which is also connected to the wired internet. So this entire part is connected through wires. And this is your mobile host which is not connected with anywhere. This is your wireless connection here, and the transmission will be or data will be communicated between this mobile host and the correspondent host. So I am trying to read one by one point and I will explain with these figures. Okay, so it clears your concept. If you see this figure here, the communication will be showing from mobile host to the correspondent host with this particular line or this arrow, two-headed arrow. It shows that the end-to-end TCP connection is established. But in between them, this access point act as a buffering element or buffering means he always snoops this particular line to check what are the data going on between the mobile host and the correspondent host, and what are the acknowledgement are going on inside this particular line. By snooping that data, he will take decision whether, suppose a packet get lost, how to retransmit it, how to block the negative acknowledgement, everything he will taking care of. So let us read one by one. The foreign agent buffers all packet. Here this access point is acting as a foreign agent. Buffers all packets with destination mobile host and additionally snoops the packet flow in both direction to recognize acknowledgement. So he is snooping this particular line and checks what are the data get transmitted, means what are the packets transmitted and what are the acknowledgements. Means it see both the direction, okay. And whenever a packet sends will be transferred from the correspondent host to the mobile host, that packet is sent to mobile host along with buffered inside this access point. Access point store that data and transfer it. Why he is storing this data? Because when if and if anyhow, because generally what happened, the wireless connections are erroneous. So there will be lots of chances that data get lost in between this communication. So if that happens, he will take care of it. Access point will take care of it, or the foreign agent will take care of it, and he will not let the duplicate acknowledgement to send to this corresponding host. Okay, so read it properly. The reason for buffering packets, why he is buffering the packet towards the mobile node, is to enable the foreign agent to perform local retransmission in case of packet loss or wireless link. I have just now discussed that if somehow, if any means, if the packet get lost, then this foreign agent will retransmit the data, or that is called local retransmission. He will retransmit the entire data to this mobile host. That's why he is buffering that data. The foreign agent buffers every packet until it receives an acknowledgement from the mobile host. So he will buffer every data until and unless he checks an acknowledgement coming from the mobile host. Okay, whenever an acknowledgement came, he may delete that packet, or it may not be needed to store that. Fine. Next point. If the foreign agent does not receive an acknowledgement from the mobile host, suppose one message has already been sent from this correspondent host. Let's, this is the message. This message will be delivered here, right? And this message is also stored over here. Two things will be happening in a connection. So this particular message is stored over here. This is stored. Here it is delivered. Okay. These two things he has to check. Somehow, let's say, if foreign agent does not receive any acknowledgement from the mobile host within a certain amount of time. So when he stored this, he will start a timer. If you know that in TCP connection, a timer timeout period will be taken care of. Similarly, a timer is also there in the correspondent host, and a timer is also there in the access point. So he will set the timer, and if somehow, let's say, this message is not delivered and may be lost in this transition between the access point to this, then within certain amount of time, either the packet or the acknowledgement has been lost. So he assumes that either the packet get lost, or if mobile host has already received it and send an acknowledgement, the acknowledgement may be get lost. So alternatively, the foreign agent could receive a duplicate SEK, which also shows that loss of packets. So that another one is either packet loss, either acknowledgement lost, or if the packet lost, then a duplicate acknowledgement will be sent from the, this is your duplicate acknowledgement, which will be sent from your mobile host to the correspondent host, that also snooped by your access point. So in all the three cases, the packet has been lost. So now what the foreign agent will do? Now the foreign agent retransmit the packet directly from the buffer, because he has already stored the message in the buffer, performing a much faster retransmission compared to the correspondent host. So assume that if duplicate acknowledgement will be generated by mobile host, it takes lots of time to reach the correspondent host. So without waiting for that, he may not allow the duplicate acknowledgement to receive over there. Maybe allow the duplicate allotment will be there, he will resend the data from the stored buffer to this mobile host immediately. Okay, that's why that is the easiest way to communicate with the mobile device. Fine. So we know that we need to be transparent, because correspondent node should know all these communications between the mobile host and the correspondent host. So to remain transparent, the foreign agent must not acknowledge data to the correspondent host. That means, suppose the foreign agent must not acknowledge data to the correspondent host. So that means he will not send any acknowledgement to the correspondent host. Otherwise, during retransmission, if he will send the acknowledgement, then maybe the correspondent host is going to send the packet again. That will be a problem. The foreign agent can filter the duplicate acknowledgement, as I have already told you, to avoid unnecessary retransmission of data from the correspondent host. So let me discuss this particular point clearly, so that you can easily understand what the access point is doing actually. Let's say the correspondent host sends a packet in this link. Okay, this is the link actually, the message is transferred in that link. This is just showing the end-to-end TCP connection. So let's say the correspondent node sends a packet to the mobile host, and this message gets stored in here by the access point and get delivered over here. So during the delivery, assume that the message has not been transferred to your mobile host. Somehow it get deleted, means somehow it get lost or dropped. Let's say either it is dropped. If it is dropped, then mobile host did not get that message. So what the mobile host will do? He will reply with a duplicate acknowledgement. Okay, he will reply with a duplicate acknowledgement. If it is a duplicate acknowledgement, then the message is already buffered in your access point. So this duplicate acknowledgement packet is going on inside the link. Access point receives that and he saw that this is a duplicate acknowledgement. So he should not forward the duplicate acknowledgement to the correspondent host. Why? Because the data the mobile host is looking for is already there in his buffer. So he will send that packet to the mobile host. So he will send that packet immediately to the mobile host on receiving a duplicate acknowledgement. And don't allow this duplicate acknowledgement, that means filter it, not to allow the duplicate acknowledgement to the correspondent host. Assume that if he allows the duplicate acknowledgement, what will happen? The same message has to be sent from the correspondent host and it will take lots of time to reach over here. Okay, so that's why the local retransmission is a better option. Okay, so that's why, so the unnecessary retransmission of data from correspondent host, so this will be avoided by your foreign agent. If the foreign agent now crashes, so somehow if you remember in ITCP, if the foreign agent crashes, then the entire communication get lost, means everything is get lost, means no packet is going to be delivered to the mobile host. But now see, in this scenario, what will happen? The connection still be there. If the foreign agent now crashes, the timeout of the correspondent host still works and trigger a retransmission. Suppose he has sent a duplicate acknowledgement and in the meantime, the access point was dead, maybe. So there is an end-to-end connection between the correspondent host to the mobile host. So that duplicate acknowledgement somehow reached to the correspondent host, duplicate acknowledgement. And by seeing that duplicate acknowledgement, the correspondent host again sends the message to the mobile host. So in this particular scenario, what will happen? Even if the access point get dead, the end-to-end delivery will be intact. Okay, that's all for this 3 point. Finally, the foreign agent may discard duplicate of packets already transmitted locally and acknowledged by the mobile host. The foreign agent may discard duplicates of packets already retransmitted locally and acknowledged by the mobile host. This avoid unnecessary traffic on the wireless link. So retransmitted acknowledgement must be handled by your access agent. Fine. let us see how the other way is done. So now we are discussing about the correspondent host is sending the data to mobile host, and there is lots of chances that the data get lost in this particular wireless area. Now data transfer from mobile host with destination correspondent host. So suppose mobile host is trying to send some data, what will happen? There is a concept called negative acknowledgement is introduced over here, which was not there in TCP. So let us see what happened over there. The foreign agent snoops into the packet stream to detect the gaps in the sequence number of the TCP. So when mobile host is sending that packet, so the access point will always snoop this line, or the line which is connected from your mobile host to the correspondent host, to check for the sequence number. If any gap in the sequence number, then what the access point will do? As soon as the foreign agent detects a missing packet, it returns a negative acknowledgement to the mobile host. So he immediately sends a negative acknowledgement. So when the mobile host receives the negative acknowledgement, then he has to retransmit the data. So the mobile host can now retransmit the missing packet immediately. That is done by your access point. Then reordering of packet is done automatically at the correspondent host by the TCP. So when the data gets received by the correspondent host, rearranging, suppose first data received, then the third data received, then let's say seventh data received, and after that fourth data is received, fourth sequence number is received. So arrangement is done by your correspondent host. So this is how the snooping TCP work. That's all about snooping TCP. Let us discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of snooping TCP. Advantages of snooping TCP. So as we have already told you that this process, the end-to-end TCP semantics is preserved. So if you see the figure, you can easily say that the end-to-end connection is established over there, which is the requirement for the traditional TCP, and that helps in your reliable data transmission. Then second one, the approach automatically falls back to the standard TCP if the enhancements stop working. So that means, suppose in this particular situation, see here, suppose somehow let's say this is get dead. So what the second point telling that? It tells that the approach automatically falls back to standard TCP. That will be converted into standard TCP if the enhancements stop working. So what is the enhancement actually here? The enhancement is giving capability to the access point to buffer the packet and snoop this particular communication. Snooping means checking what are the data going on between mobile host and the correspondent host. So that facility, if this one will be dropped or having some problem in this access device, this entire communication is nothing but the communication between the mobile host and the correspondent host is nothing but the standard TCP connection or end-to-end standard TCP connection. That I am trying to say so over here within the advantage. So that means when the enhancements stop working, then it automatically fall into standard TCP. Fine. The next point is the correspondent host does not need to be changed. Most of the enhancements are in the foreign agent. So he is saying that we don't need any modification in the correspondent host. We only increase the capability of an access point. Means we give any enhancement according to snooping TCP. Lots of enhancement has been implemented on the access point only. So correspondent host does not know about this, that whenever I am sending a packet, it will be snooped by somebody else. So he is just sending the packet and thinking that I am directly connected or logically connected to the mobile host to whom I am sending the packets. That is another advantage. Then the next one is, it does not need a handover of states as soon as the mobile host moves to another foreign agent. So if you remember, suppose this is the access point, another access point, let's say connected over here. Okay, let's say this is your another access point. Now the mobile host moves from this place to this place. Then if you remember in indirect TCP, what will happen? The state information which was stored inside the access point need to be transferred here. What are the state information? Socket number, port number, your sequence number, everything need to be transferred. But in this particular case, this state information transformation is not needed. Fine, that is another advantage of this technique. It does not matter if the next foreign agent uses the enhancement or not. If not, the approach automatically falls back to standard solution. So what does it mean? Suppose in this particular case, when the mobile host has been transferred from one location to the other location, if the enhancement which is applicable to this access point is not applicable to this point, then the communication is actually taking place between the correspondent host and the mobile host like a normal TCP or the traditional TCP. If the enhancement is not applied to access point, if it is applied, then whatever system we have discussed in the previous slides, that will be applicable to here. So if not, then traditional TCP will be going on. So there will be no problem in this communication. Fine. So these are the advantages of snooping TCP. Let us go for discussion on the disadvantage. So what are the disadvantages? The first disadvantage is using negative acknowledgement. As I have already told you, that is a negative acknowledgement happen when it will happen. Suppose the mobile host is trying to send a packet to this and somehow the packet is not received properly, then a negative NAC will be sent from your access point or the foreign agent to the mobile host, right? So the disadvantage is using negative acknowledgement between the foreign agent and the mobile host assumes additional mechanism on the mobile host. That means TCP, traditional TCP, does not have the mechanism of NAC or negative acknowledgement. So we need some additional mechanism to make it compatible with your snooping TCP. All efforts for snooping TCP and buffering data may be useless if certain encryption scheme are applied to end-to-end between the correspondent host and the mobile host. So what happened in this case? See, in this particular case, there is no, means we are not thinking about the security issues. Let's say there will be a security mechanism will be implemented, let us say. So when a security mechanism will be implemented, then the packet which are sent from this correspondent host need to be protected for end-to-end delivery. So if the packet is get delivered from here to here, get encrypted, then this snooping facility will be not available to this access point. So if he is not able to snoop the packet, then there will be a issue on the enhancement which are provided to this access point. So that is another disadvantage. So what I have written for that, we have written using IP encapsulation security payload, the TCP protocol header will be encrypted. That's why snooping on the sequence number will no longer work. So snooping of sequence number is difficult, and that is the disadvantage of snooping TCP. So that's all about your snooping TCP. I hope you people have understood the concept. If you have any doubt, then put your questions on the comment line. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.